Today I want to show you how to make an Instax Mini camera into a back for the RB67 so you can play around with Instax film. So first you need, of course, a camera. Got one here. And then you need an adapter, which I made here. All right, so first of all, we need to prepare the camera. All right. And we need to open it, which is done quite easily by removing all the screws. I'm probably gonna speed this up just not to bore you guys. And there's also one hiding in here, but yeah, when we crack it open, it's easier to get to. I don't know why this is so stuck together, like somebody glued it. Ah, there we go. And then you lift this one up. Gonna find that later. And the screws are about the same length, so you don't really need to keep track of them. Here's the back, which we will use, and we need to get everything out of the front, which we will not use. So that's as easy as that. Parts come out here and there. This is your shutter button. We're gonna reuse that, so keep it safe with the other parts. This one is stuck with a very, very annoying little spring. It's kind of hard to fish off, but it can be done. There we go. And we are not gonna use anything from this part, so that can be discarded. Next up, you can go for the solution where you want to reuse all the electronics, so you just do a one button press and the film will eject and so on, but it's quite hard to fit this print with the flash and all that. So in my design, I actually just get rid of all this. We don't use it at all. So more screws to unscrew. Be careful not to touch these open leads here, because there's the charger here, the capacitor that charges the flash. It's on 320 volts, and you guessed it, I kind of touched it a few times, and it's a nasty surprise. There is one more screw here, so the print is screwed with this one and this one. This part is also for the shutter button. This little thing, it's what gives the springy motion. So we're gonna save that as well. And I believe, careful here, yeah, we can take everything off. This is the actual on-off switch if you want to keep the electronics. Do not damage these little switches. It's just held on by a screw here. I hope you can see all this. Or else feel free to message me if you have any questions. Yet another little screw. All right. And the other one we can get to as soon as we have freed up the lens. And it's held on by 5 screws. There's a screw in each corner, and then a fifth one that is really annoying to get to, but We have to cut some parts anyway, so it will not be too much of a hassle. It's also, it's nice to have some tweezers or small pliers like this to grab hold of the screws. It kind of eases everything. So there are some things to be aware of. This little spring, we are gonna need this for later. We're gonna move the attachment part down here to this screw hole once the lens is gone, because we will be cutting off all this plastic. We need to trim everything down a lot to make the adapter fit. I think it's actually just cut it here. There you go. And the lens is almost free. You could do a more gentle disassembly if you want to reuse the lens for something. I don't know why you would. It's not really good quality. All right. So most of these wires are going to be cut off as well. Beware of parts that can fall out. This one is very poorly glued in there from the factory side, so it will eventually go. So I'm gonna re-glue that with hot glue a bit later on in the process. But let's get all these wires moved out of the way. And I'm gonna cut this clip. It's this clip holding all the wires. We don't really need it. I forgot to mention the other switch that I took off the lens, this one. I honestly don't really know what it does. I think it checks the position of the f-stops, if you chose the correct position according to what the light meter said here. So it's non-vital at all. Let's see, is this blue wire glued in there? It looks like it. Okay, so for some, here is the painful part where I do not save the print. I actually just cut away one by one. I do it one by one because these two leads are for this capacitor and I really, really don't want to short circuit it. These two you can just cut. All right, and all this. The red and the white here is for the LED, little red one. It is located there. It just lights up red whenever you run the motor. So I just like to keep it. And I'm still gonna try to remember not to touch anything like this brown and white. In fact, I will cut them off a bit closer. There we go. All right. Then for the shutter button, those are the yellow wires. And for now, I just cut them off as close as I can to the print, so I have as much wire to work with as possible. The blue and the green is for running the actual motor, which we need as well. And the orange here, we don't need at all. I'm just gonna cut it off in close. All right, bye-bye camera intelligence. This is now done. Okay, next up, this one is really tricky to remove. We kind of have to Remove the battery cover, not cover, the battery holder. It has two screws there, it has one screw here, and it has one screw here. When you remove it, there's a spring for the image counter. Just make sure it's not gonna go flying, or at least try. Let's see, yeah. It's currently hooked over here, but that peg will be gone. So we're gonna screw it to this one, holder instead, when we put everything back. They're pretty much the same size. It's not really important where they were or where they will go. So it still feels like it's stuck over here. It's just a little plastic clip, so you just gotta persuade it a little bit. There you go. Now you can put this down, and as you see, this spring, as mentioned before, we're gonna move it to here. It does a perfectly fine job being over here as well. All right. This little thing that manipulates the switch. I realized I ran out of space, so let's just do a quick recap. I have moved a little screw here. This was basically holding the lens to the camera, the one that was hard to get to. I removed a screw here because I will be trimming off all this as far down as I can. Don't trim the sprocket, okay? But try to trim all the plastic here. That makes it able to fit inside this little cave here. Yeah. So basically now it's just all the brutal cutting. Close your mouth, close your eyes when you cut, because this is really flying. I also moved the spring. It was attached up here. Now I attach it here with a screw. A little bit fiddly, but it works like this. So first, get these thingies out of the way. Makes it easier to when you trim here. Up. Be careful with this sprocket. There we go, that's about as far as we need to go down. Here you have to push this sprocket a little bit. See if you can get in there without breaking anything that shouldn't break. There we go, it came off clean. This is about the level we need to go down to. I wonder if I'm gonna find all these pieces after. We can keep the viewfinder in for now. Let's see if it will fit. I actually don't know. But now we are about down to the mechanism that we need for the back. So without hooking all this up for now, well, a little more trimming actually. We need to get this out. It's glued in with double-sided tape, and it's, this one was not so bad. The capacitors, as mentioned before, do not touch there. We gotta cut the holder off for the capacitor, and also the plastic here around this button. Try to keep these pegs. It makes it easier if we can save this whole piece. It's kind of prone to break when you cut it, but yeah, try to be careful. And this one is really flying. The black one was not so bad. And this is when you cut here. This plate sometimes breaks in half. I didn't find a better way to cut it. A Dremel would be a better choice, but I have none. Oh, looks like we are in luck this time. I hope. Let's not jinx it. Cut it under. There you go. The shutter button for later mounting on the outside. And this one, if it doesn't fit, you can trim it down with a hobby knife or sandpaper, but it should be all right like this. All right, so now we have a battery box, which will fit in exactly where we took it from. We just need to remember to reattach the little counter wheel, and you attach it with the S facing out. And if you put it in and it has a natural stop there, that means you put it in correctly. We have to screw it into now this hole instead. I don't know if you can see, it's a very small hole. Was much better. I don't know if you can see this, but the idea is to get it into that hole here. And success. You don't need to tighten it all the way and make the it skipped. There we go. All right. Perfect. Let's see. Before we put that back in place, let's remove the isolation here from the wires a little bit. There we go, it clicked in place. Gonna put the screws back. So far so good. We're still gonna have all the fun with the wires. Let's take a quick look at what we need to do here. I think I have to trim down some more pegs, but let's see. So this crease, I made a matching one here. See, I did not clean it out yet, but that will ultimately fit in here. Just gonna hold it on for now to see if we need to trim any more things. think we're pretty good. I'm gonna lose this one pick. And this one surely is not needed for nothing. All right, there you have it. So we can keep the viewfinder. At least that's nice. Gives a better end result, better finish. All right, so maybe this is time for doing the wires, the wiring. I'm just gonna rearrange, clean up a little bit before I do that. I have removed the isolations from the wires here. So now we're just basically gotta wire it with what we have. So from the plus side, the motor is plus, the blue. I'm gonna twist those two together just for now. I have to solder it later. My new soldering iron is not in, and the old one kind of shorted out on me, so I cannot solder it for now, but I can show you the principle of connecting the wires at least. Then we need, from the shutter button, to the negative of the battery box.
Right, and from the negative through the button, and we want to hit the negative of the motor, and then we have the optional LED. The negative is white. You will put it along with the negative from the switch to. To the negative of the motor, and get these three together, and then the positive side of the LED. Oops, you will put together this bundle. Oh, need to remove some isolation further down. There are tools for this. Tools which I don't have at the moment.
Positive from the battery box to the positive of the motor and the positive of the LED. The negative on the battery box to the shutter switch, to the negative of the LED and the negative of the motor. All right. Now it's all about fiddling all the wiring through here. So the shutter button will come out here, and there will be no on-off button, so it's quite easy. You just simply activate everything with the shutter button. I will show you later on how that functions. All right, so in the meanwhile I have cleaned this up here, so now it should actually fit nicely and make a light seal. There you go, it fits almost perfectly. We do have some more things to trim. Let's see, we might lose that viewfinder after all. Yeah, looks like it. All right. It's just held on with this one screw, so it's not really a big deal to remove, and then we can take care of the LED later on. Let's see how much more. I think I saw this one being too tall. this little guy. We have to check that it's flush all the way around here. As long as it's not flush, there was something that needs some cutting. It can be a little hard to see what it is. Looks like this part here needs to go as well. Again, close your eyes and mouth while cutting, or wear safety glasses, because it's really unpleasant to get it into your eye. Oh, there we go. Now it sits flush all the way around. This one I'm uncertain of, so if it's not there, it's not causing a problem, right? And you can feel it when it sits in place, you cannot move it around. So far, so good. Now back to the wiring, which I cannot do at the moment because I don't have soldering iron, but hopefully you get the idea. Everything is, after this, we're gonna reuse the backside because it has this door with all these details. You could probably make a nice enclosure for everything, but this is a quick dirty hack. Frankinstax, as I call it. Yep. Once the wires are cleaned up and soldered, I will continue. All right, so I have cheated a little bit, only a tiny bit. I have had the chance to actually solder the connections and protected them with the crimping material like this. Not this size, but much smaller one. This is about the right size you need. Or you can use electrical tape if you don't have the other stuff. So what I'm gonna do now, I am gonna hot glue just a little bit, and before I mention this plastic piece, can I give it a little kiss here and there? Right, that will go nowhere. This one, however, I'm not so sure. Right, make sure to route the wires behind here. I decided to save the viewfinder. I just cut off this little piece, so the adapter will clear it. But we're getting ahead. So next thing up, just want to make sure again that we still have full clearance. We do. All right, so this is a vital part of the process. You dab a little hot glue in each corner here. Just a tiny bit is enough. Just make sure it's not going all over the place, and you only have a few seconds to position this and press together and hold. Press as hard as you can, as if dear life was depending on it. We can try to speed it up a little bit. Okay, now that those points are dry, I always like to just run one time to see, is it everything working? Yep. Systems are go. Then I'm gonna re-glue. I'm gonna glue additional spots just to make sure that it's not gonna go anywhere. Make some supports here and there. For the time being, my glue gun is charging. It ran out of power. So once it's charged, I'm gonna fill up this gap with glue. I am gonna get a little glue here. Careful not to get it on the end of the engine, because then, not the engine, the motor, because it cannot turn then. And do not get it into any sprockets, but just here and there, you know, where you can get some spots done. All right, I'll be back right after gluing. As you can see, I have added a healthy amount of hot glue just to make sure that these two parts are not really gonna separate unexpectedly. It's gonna be quite hard to take them apart by now. And it's always important to test if the systems are still working. It would be pretty shitty now, but it's still doing just exactly as it should. All right, so we can go ahead and mount the back. There we go. It's gonna fit nicely back where it should be. See, we have some glue here on this part. Sometimes things fit too nicely back together. We don't want glue where the pictures are coming out. There we go. And before we mount it, I think I am gonna glue this in place here. Alright, I'm gonna do that with super glue, because hot glue is gonna look absolutely terrible. Just a few dots will do the trick. Like so. Right, just a few seconds and it's gonna be stuck on there for good. There we go. All right. So we're gonna put these guys back together. And now is when your screws from before, they come back, and now you just close it all up. So for the last part, we're gonna glue this on, and I like to glue it on just about here, just to make it easy to eject. All right, I have just applied the hot glue here. And it rests nicely in this little, yeah, sorry, I don't know English, it's not my native language, as you may notice. But here, I'm gonna glue it in here. And then I'm just gonna stuff the wires inside, so if at a later moment I want to open the wires are long enough to actually open the back. but this is it. And then I am gonna put this little thing back. This is the spring for the eject button, like so. The eject button itself. Like that. And I'm just gonna put a little dab of hot glue on the ends so the button will stay. And then just hold it in for a little while. You can probably find a better way of securing the button, but this has proven to work fine so far. Just gonna try to shove the wires in a little better so they won't come out. Frankinstax back for the RB67. And in a little while, I'm actually gonna mount it and shoot it just to make sure that it works. But this is the assembly in, let's say, short, but yeah. Thank you for watching, guys.